Welcome to QuickBooks Online for Nonprofits. My name is Ufuma Ogaga. I am the owner of Goshen Bookkeeping and Consulting. I am a financial controller and a QuickBooks Pro Advisor, helping nonprofits to increase profitability one mission at a time. Today I'm going to show you how to add users, invite your accountant, as well as manage existing users in QuickBooks Online. QuickBooks Online Plus Edition gives you 5 user seats, 2 accounting firm seats, and unlimited reports only and unlimited time tracking only seats. To manage users in QuickBooks Online, click the gear icon, then select Manage Users. To add a new user in QuickBooks Online, click the green Add User button. Note that you must allow pop-ups in your browser in order to add a new user. So go ahead and take care of that if you have not done so. In this screen, choose the type of user you want to add. You could choose the standard user to give them full access to your company file without administrative rights. Then click Next. In the Access Rights screen, you can limit what this user can see. So you could choose the All option, or you could choose None option, or you could choose Limited View option and then select if they need to view only customers or if they can view only vendors. This is a great option if you have separate departments or if you have separate individuals handling the accounts receivable process and the accounts payable process of your nonprofit. Once you choose your option, you will click Next. Now, under this user settings screen, QuickBooks will ask you, do you want this user to be able to add other users? Do you want them to be able to change your company information? Do you want them to be able to manage your company subscription? I tend to recommend that my nonprofit do not give standard users any access to your user settings. You should typically choose the No option or the View Only option in this screen. So click Next. Here, QuickBooks will ask you to enter the first and last name and the email address of the individual you're trying to add. Once you enter that information and you click Next, it's going to send an email to that individual with a link for them to activate their QuickBooks Online account. So I'm going to do that entire process now, and then I'm going to click Save. Click on the green Add User button again. You can choose a company administrator type to give full access rights to all of the services in your QuickBooks company file. I recommend adding 2 company administrators to your company file to use in recording transactions and to serve as a backup in an event something happens to your master administrator. Then leave the master administrator account that you set up from TechSoup strictly for billing purposes. You can set up 1 administrator to have full access with the ability to change the billing and the subscription information as well as add new users. And you can make the other company admin have the same full access but without the ability to change the billing and subscription information. When you click on Company Administrator, you can also check the box that says this user is an accountant and complete the prior steps that I showed you to invite them into the system. This is how you invite an accountant into your QuickBooks file. Reports-only user logs into a special version of QuickBooks Online that gives them the ability to access almost all reports except payroll and list reports that includes contact information. This is the option to set up for your board members, your committee members, or your treasurer users that need access to QuickBooks Online without giving them the ability to edit your data. If you are using QuickBooks Online Payroll Service, you can set up the time tracking user type. The time tracking only user logs into a different special version of QuickBooks Online that allows them to be able to enter their own timesheets. Once you go through the process of adding users, all of the users that you have added will show up here, and the status of the invites will show under the status column. The type of user will show under the user column. You can view the action or the activity of each user by going under the action column to do so. Your accountant user will appear in the accounting firm's tab. That is how to add and manage users in QuickBooks Online. Thank you for watching.